Hi, in this episode, we'll show how to put a hyperlink to a document. So first of all, we have an account. The account has an account name and a website. So this website link we want to put on our documents. Cool, so now we know which data to get. Let's first update the data source. I'll start from an opportunity data source because this is one I already have. And I'll simply use the SQL builder to add our fields that we need. So I go to the selected fields. I follow the relation from opportunity to account. And on this one, I can just filter on website. So add the fields, go to review. You will see the field is now here and just save the query. Okay, this is done. That was the easy part. Now let's create a doc config. So we'll create a new one starting from scratch, a main Word document, and we'll call it Summer 19 Hyperlink Demo. Okay, so I'll just, the title can be the same. I don't want to store it anywhere in Salesforce, so I'll just put it to page 64. So our document is now here. Everything is fine. Let's open up PDF Butler configuration. Everybody knows how to do that. And let's start configuring. First of all, upload our document. Okay, so I'll go for this one. I'll give it an alternative name that's required. Select the data source. So it was the opportunity data source. So you see that the account website is there and the account name. That's all that we will need for this demo. Okay, click OK. Let's take a look at our template. Our template looks very easy. It's only a demo, but you can imagine to use this in any of your business use cases. I have one link, and in this link, I want to have the account name as the text of the link and the website of the account as the URL sitting behind the link. In my second example, I want to have the account name as the text on the URL, but the URL I wanted to point to pdfbutler.com. And in the last one, I want a static text saying website URL, and I want the URL to link to the website that's linked to the account in Salesforce. So lots of different options to configure this entire thing. So let's start configuring. I copy the merge field from here, and I'll just put it in as a config type. So a new config type, I'll select the type link. I'll select a data source that I want to link to it. I want a custom label, and because it's going to come from a field, it's going to be the account name. I want a custom URL because it's going to come from a field in Salesforce. It's the account website. The merge field is link one. Okay, that's the first one. Second one is link two. So I'll just copy this one. Oh, this is not correct. Okay, copy it. Then I'll go to link. I'll select a new data source. I want to have it a custom label, say the account name, and I want to have a static URL is selected here. So we go for pdfbutler.com. Okay, merge field is link two. Okay, and there was a third one, and the third one says link three. Okay, that's the name. I'll select the hyperlink stuff here. We'll go for a data source. We wanted a custom label, so we wanted to use the account name. And no, we wanted a static label, so we wanted here website. Okay, and we want a custom URL. That's the account website. Merge field link three. Okay, let's save it. It's already done. No errors, everything is fine. So let's continue with the demo. For I have to configure now the .config to generate. So I'll just copy this ID from the URL. Okay, use this URL inside our Lightning component. So very easy, just go here to edit page. The Lightning component will be on the page, and on this page we will just add this ID in the list of IDs to select. So here I'll just add it, comma, paste the ID, click save. You see it's already there, and go back. Okay, all is done, all is configured. Now it's time to generate our documents. Simple click on the button. Whoa, it's already there. That was fast. And what we see is that we have perfectly the example that we wanted. So in the first case, we wanted the account name to have the text of the hyperlink. That's correct. And indeed, the hyperlink says burlington.com. So if I go open it in a new tab, you see burlington.com. Okay, the second hyperlink, I wanted the account name. That's correct. And I wanted to point to pdfbutter.com, a static URL. That's also correct. So let's take a look. Yeah, points to pdfbutter.com. That's fine. And the last, not the least one, we wanted a static text saying website. So it does that. And also it points to the account name. That's Burlington in this case. So I can just open up the website from the account. Looks good. All the hyperlinks are there. Our training is done. Everybody can now use it. So please enjoy it. Thank you very much.